girls, welcome back to my channel. And this, if this is your first, please don't make it your last by subscribing down below. My name is Tolulope and I create content that relates to my lifestyle, my fashion, my beauty, my DIYs, my travel and fitness activities. If you are interested in those kind of content, please consider subscribing and keep on watching. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how I achieved this gorgeousness and the Mielle Hawaiian Ginger Moisture Collection. I got the shampoo, I got the ginger, and I got the moisturizing butter. All right, guys. So before I continue, I would like to let you guys know that whatever your hair type is, whatever the texture, be it relaxed or natural, your hair is absolutely gorgeous. So I'll be trying the Mielle Moisture Ares, the Hawaiian Ginger Collection. The product claims to deliver moisture and hydration to condition every hair strand. So we are going to see that in the subsequent video, if this really delivers what it claims to do. So my hair is a combination hair type. I have mixture of 4A, 4B and 4C. That's why I like to refer to my hair as being the combination hair type. So you have to take care of your hair, be it relaxed or natural, because all our hair deserves to be careful. So in this spray bottle, I have mixture of water and my leave-in conditioner. This is what I will use to detangle my hair. So this bond, I will use it in sectioning my hair into four parts. Sectioning your hair before detangling enables you to properly detangle your hair and also thereby reducing breakage, because you are doing it in section. You can, however, split your hair into different sections depending on the length of your hair. My hair is long enough for me to section it into four parts. If your hair is not as long as mine, you can section it into six or eight parts. If you understand what I mean, just do whatever suits you and your hair length. So that is what I'm doing here. So I'll make sure I section the other part. So the goal is to achieve four puffs in all. So while I'm doing that, I'm just going to take you guys the major reason why you should section your hair before you detangle. One, it saves time. Two, it reduces the amount of hair you will lose, because naturally you are supposed to shed hair when you have kept your hair in a protective hairstyle for more than 2 or 3 weeks, because naturally you are supposed to shed hair every day. I think it's about 1.5 strands of hair that you are supposed to shed every day. I'm not sure. I'll confirm that and put it on the screen. So now I've started detangling the hair. So what I basically do is to split my hair with the water and leave-in conditioner mixture, fluff it out with my hand, then go in with my wide tooth comb before I pack this section back. Please notice that I started combing my hair from the tip and not the root. So you are supposed to comb from the tip to the root and not from the root to the tip. If you comb from the root to the tip, you are going to lose a lot of hair. So it's better you comb from the tip, thereby reducing any knots that might be hanging, before you comb the root. So you see that I still use my finger to further fluff out my hair. In case there are some knots hanging in there, then I'm going to pack it back before I move to the next section. Now I'm moving into the second section. Then I'm going to basically repeat the same thing. Split my hair with the water and leave-in conditioner mixture that I've done in my spray bottle. Then after that, gently use my hand to fluff out my hair, or further divide it into smaller sections to remove any knots. I'm also properly detangle my hair. So that is what I am doing here. And guys, be gentle with your hair. You are not fighting with it. Be gentle. If you are kind to your hair, it's going to be kind to you by growing. So that is what I am doing here. I'm going to add more water if need be, but I'm not done with this section yet. You can see I'm using my fingers. It's easier to use your finger because you can control the movement of your finger rather than using comb. So I'm adding more water here. Then I use my hand to further fluff out, use my finger, I mean, to further fluff out my hair before going in with the comb. So I'm going to stop here to allow you guys see what I'll do to allow you guys wash. It's basically the same process that I have done to the first and second puff that I am going to do to the third and the fourth one. So just watch as I do that, and I'm showing you the comb here to shows that to show that I am not losing any hair. At the end of the detangling process, I'm going to show you the total amount of the detangling process, I'm going to show you guys the amount of hair that I lost. I hope I remember to do that, but it's very, very insignificant, very, very small, because I was gentle while detangling my hair. Yeah. Off camera to shampoo my hair, and this is a video of me showing you guys my freshly washed hair. So I'm going to go ahead to condition now. So I'm about to start putting the conditioner into my freshly washed hair. So I'm going to do that too in section. So I'm going to do about one or two section here to illustrate how you guys do it. So that is the conditioner that I've rubbed in my palm, and now I am putting it into my hair, starting from the roots to the ends of my hair. So the conditioner is supposed to be saturated all over your hair, both the roots and the tip, and that is what I'm doing. So I reached out for more conditioner and I applied it in the section I am working with at the moment. So I'm using my finger to gently comb my hair now, and I'm going to pack it up. It is shake. So I'm going to pack that up now and do that to the rest of the section. Don't forget your edges. So I just used my palm to brush up my edges now and pack it up. So I left the conditioner in my hair for about 15 minutes, and man, my hair is so moisturized, it's so soft, it's so fluffy, it's so full. I don't know what other adjective to use again. I'm definitely reusing this product again, and even when I finish the bottles, I will be repurchasing, because my hair loves it. Like, see how full my hair looks, see how full and fluffy my hair looks. This is my natural hair, guys. This is my natural hair. I am so proud, I'm so happy at this point, and I'm just trying to show you guys how full my hair looks, and at the same time very, very soft. See, they shake safe. Yeah. So I have rinsed out the conditioner here,
and I'm just showing you guys how my hair looks. So I'm going now in now with my leave-in conditioner. Yeah, after rinsing out the conditioner, I'm going to go in with my deep conditioner. Now I was unable to get the Mielle leave-in conditioner at the point I was ordering, it was sold out, so I'm just going to use my Shea Moisture leave-in conditioner, which is equally good. I've been using Shea Moisture, I think this is about my third or fourth bottle or cup, whatever. So I'm just putting it into my hair, my entire hair, from the tip, the roots, just mine, or every part of my hair. I beg, I'm tired. So that's what I am doing at this point. So I'm going to reach out for more conditioner and apply it to my hair, so that my hair can properly soak in all the moisture that it needs to flourish. Yeah. This is the last step of my wash day routine. I'm sure some of you will be wondering that where is the oil? Okay guys, I've stopped applying oils into my hair, as I've noticed that it really does not do any justice to my hair. Even if I must apply oil to my hair, I'm going to mix it with my moisturizing butter. But because of the way this product, that is the shampoo and conditioner, has worked so far, there is really no need for me to include any oil, because my hair is already soft and very fluffy already, so there won't be need for that. So I'm just applying the butter here and combing out my hair. Guys, my Mielle Organic Hawaiian Ginger infused with avocado really works. Like, it is really moisturizing, as the product claim. So this is me giving you my sincere unsponsored opinion that the collection is really the truth. I really love to get the leave-in conditioner and see how well that we do. So I'm just twisting some part of my hair now before I go to have my bath. Then I'm going to come back to you guys with my big fro to close out this video. I hope you guys did not find this video boring, because I was just trying to take you guys step by step how I do my wash day routine when I don't have much time. And also hope I did okay with my voiceover. Please let me know in the comment section if I did okay with my voiceover. Then see you guys at the other end when I come to close out this video. Bye for now.
Thank you guys for watching. At the time I was filming this video, we are currently at 118 subscribers. Oop. Thank you guys so much for subscribing. And if you are not yet subscribed, please subscribe down below, so that by the end of next week we'll be at least 200 or 250 subscribers. So a quick review of the product. I'm sure you must have seen in the various clip that the product really lives to its claim by giving my hair deep moisturizing effect. As you can see, my hair is very soft and fluffy, but it is worthy of note that the shampoo is a moisturizing shampoo and not a clarifying shampoo. So in case you have existing dry scalp, product buildup, some dandruff, this shampoo will not be the best for you. I would advise you get a clarifying shampoo. Mind your way next time. Remain blessed. Bye.